space friends, this week I'm talking about other solar systems. It turns out there are other solar systems in our universe other than our own. I know, right? Well, specifically, I wanted to show you actual videos of actual planets in other solar systems. Nerd alert, these planets in other solar systems are usually called exoplanets, short for extrasolar planets, as designated by scientists to say that these planets are not in the cool kids solar system, which is, of course, our solar system as decided by us. But I'm just going to be calling them planets. The first video that's freaking amazing to me is this video of four planets around a star called HR8799, which is not the most inspiring name, but you know. The video takes place over around 7 years, taken by the Keck Observatory in Hawaii, and you can see four little points of light dancing around a star, which has been blacked out so that you don't get blinded by its overwhelming brightness. If we didn't black out the brightness around the star, you wouldn't really be able to see the planet, so that's why there's a black circle over the video. These four planets are gas planets larger than Jupiter in the Pegasus constellation that is 129 light years away from us. Technically, these exoplanets were actually the very first exoplanets to be photographed back in 1998 by the Hubble Space Telescope, but we didn't know it at the time, so it's kind of contested whether or not they are considered the very first images of exoplanets that we ever saw. The next video of pixels in space that is amazing to check out is a video of the planet Beta Pictoris b. This video was shot over a couple of years, and while it may look like you're watching someone play Pong in slow motion, you're actually seeing a planet 10 times more massive than Jupiter flying around a dusty solar system 63 light years away, as seen by a Gemini South telescope in Chile. Next, check out this video of a planet called Fomalhaut b. That's 25 light years away. Once again, the starlight has been blocked out in the center, but look over there to the right where the arrow is pointing. That's a tiny planet. Well, okay, maybe not that tiny, considering that it's at least twice as massive as Jupiter, but it's cute nevertheless. You can actually see this planet star called Fomalhaut in the night sky with your naked eye. The name Fomalhaut actually derives from Arabic as meaning the mouth of the fish. The video was taken over around 8 years by the Hubble Space Telescope, and the really cool thing about this video and imagining this planet, Fomalhaut b, is thinking about how it likely has a ring around it like Saturn, but even thicker and more luminous, and likely filled with many, many moons, which is incredibly cool to think about. Okay, so we've discovered thousands of exoplanets though, so where are the photos? Well, the way we've detected the majority of exoplanets so far has been through looking at starlight very closely to see if any of the brightness dips down. And if the brightness dips down a very tiny amount, then we might actually be witnessing an exoplanet passing in front of a star, but we don't actually see the exoplanet itself. So we don't have a lot of direct images of exoplanets, or planets as I would like to call them. So right now, with the current state of things, we only have direct images of over a dozen or so exoplanets to date. But the good news is that the future is bringing us some very geeky gifts. The James Webb Space Telescope is set to launch around 2019 and will be taking photos of other solar systems, and the WFIRST space probe will also be launching in the mid-2020s or so and will also be taking photos of other solar systems. On the ground, other telescopes will be joining our planetary paparazzi, with the European Extremely Large Telescope coming online around 2024 and the Giant Magellan Telescope coming online around 2025. Taking photos and videos of other solar systems is not just cool pixel art, but it actually also helps astronomers learn more about the orbit and atmospheres of these planets. It can help also determine if there is water or methane or carbon dioxide in them and a bunch of other cool stuff. And so that's why I'm incredibly excited to get more images and more videos of exoplanets and planets in other solar systems over time, because it's incredibly cool not just to see, to actually see all of these other solar systems, but it's also really great science. That's it for me this week, space friends. Remember to subscribe on YouTube, join my Patreon, and also I have a new show on Tested called Offworld, where I'm exploring all things space exploration and pop culture, and the very first episode is exploring the movie Contact.